Divide decimals by whole numbers. Let's try an example. 14.68 is our decimal, and it's being divided by 4, which is our whole number. We start by bringing the decimal straight up. After we write it down, we can forget about it. Treat it like regular division. First, we ask ourselves how many times 4 goes into 1. None, because the first digit taken by itself is less than the divisor. 1 is less than 4. We write 0 or leave a space above the 1. Let's group together the 1 and the 4. Ask yourself how many times 4 goes into 14. 4 goes into 14 3 times. So we write the 3 directly above the 4. Now we multiply 4 times 3. We get 12 and we write it directly underneath the 14. Now we subtract. 14 minus 12 is 2. Now we bring down the 6. Ask yourself how many times 4 goes into 26. 4 goes into 26 6 times, so we write the 6 directly above the 6. Multiply 4 by 6 and write the product directly underneath the 26. Now we subtract and we get 2. Bring down the 8. 4 goes into 28 7 times. So we write the 7 directly above the 8. Now we multiply 4 times 7. We get 28, and we write it directly below the 28. Now we subtract and we get 0. So our answer is 3.67. We can check our work by multiplying the divisor times the quotient. We get 14.68, which is the same as our dividend. So our answer is correct. Let's try another example. This time, we take a smaller decimal. We divide 648 hundred thousands by 3. We start by bringing the decimal straight up. Now we can forget about it and treat it like regular long division. First, we ask ourselves how many times 3 goes into 0. None, because 0 is less than 3. So we write a 0. Next, we ask ourselves how many 3s are in the next 0. Also 0, so we write a 0 directly above the 0. Now we do the same thing for the next 0. Don't forget to write the 0 directly above the 0. Now we ask ourselves how many 3s are in 6. There are 2 3s inside of 6. So we write 2 directly above the 6. Now we multiply 3 by 2. We write the product directly underneath the 6 and subtract. We get 0. Next, we bring down the 4. We ask ourselves how many 3s go into 4. 1 3 goes into 4. So we write a 1 directly above the 4. Multiply 3 times 1 and write the product directly underneath the 4. Now we subtract and we get 1. Bring down the 8. Now we have 18 and we ask ourselves how many times 3 goes into 18. 3 goes into 18 6 times. So we write the 6 directly above the 8. We multiply 3 by 6 to get 18, and we write it directly underneath the 18. Now we subtract and we get 0. So the answer is 216 hundred thousands. We can check our work by multiplying the divisor times the quotient. We get 648 hundred thousands, which is the same as our dividend. So our answer is correct. If you thought this video was helpful, please leave a like. For more videos like this, please subscribe.